No, they don't have the possibility of the first pick. Urgot. They still have the first pick on this time.
Moby, get it out. Right, what else is being banned? Possibilities for Maokai, Kalista.
I still expect the Kalista. Wow, they respect Steelback's Kalista.
And look at this, pretty big differences. Last time SKT was on the red side, they banned Cassiopeia, Hecarim, and Nautilus, this time shying away from the support ban, so an entirely different ban strategy coming in from SKT.
Yellowstar should get a high-impact support. Steelback should be able to get Sivir here, unless SKT are planning on taking it away.
And I think that's probably what they're going to do if they have the option. So they're probably going to try and force Fnatic into a possible Sivir first pick right here.
Whoa, no. Gragas ban, that means a first pick Rek'Sai is probably coming unless they switch it up in the last ban here as Rek'Sai.
May see.
But again, Bangi can just go to Nunu in that case.
And there's the LeBlanc to round out the bans, so that's not going to be prioritized. Rek'Sai will be the first pick. You have to assume the Sivir pick is going to come in here for SK Telecom.
Yeah, I would definitely say the Sivir. Plus, I don't know about this Rek'Sai takeaway. They've been having such success with Rain over on Gragas, letting Bangi have the Rek'Sai, and now, oh.
Sejuani, not a champion that Bangi has played a lot, and he has not had the best ultimates either when he has gotten his hands on it.
So, if they do go through with it, and if they want to continue to play the safer farming for the early game and the waiting game, then Sejuani plays right into that. Because if you're just going to plan on farming anyway and you're not going to make those early moves, that's the jungler right now that you want on your team. She has the huge impact ultimates. Yes, when you first start playing her, maybe you got a little bit of Butterfingers and the ultimate goes a little bit wide because some people are thrown off. The explosion radius is even bigger than the actual missile width. But it's actually really easy to land once you get in enough time on her.
And it has been quite a while.
And it's been a while.
Since we've seen Bangi play. So a lot more time to practice some of those skill shots. We'll have to see how he does on that champion. Now, of course, we did see Bang with that preferential matchup really dealing a lot of damage to the Sivir in lane with the Lucian. So good matchup if he can make it work.
I'm really scared of what Bang is going to do because the game on Ezreal, if that is showing what's to come here, because he's going to really have a big impact on the mid game here with Sivir.
And it was, of course, Bang that got that penta kill on the Lucian yesterday in that matchup. Cassiopeia locked in. We know it's a flex. Both Febiven and Huni have run it. Going to give Fnatic a little bit of options to decide where they put that champion. SK Telecom decide where do they want to lock in next. Most likely top laner and support. Leave the option to counter pick once they know the two solo lanes of Fnatic.
I'm curious, they can go with Gnar here if they want to have something a little bit on the safer side. I think that's probably going to be kind of the best pickup right here because you don't want to end up in that 1v1 with a melee versus Cassiopeia. We talked about that last game.
Also, then you can threaten the Frozen Mallet build, which is good against Hecarim.
Yeah, great point. So they are going to take the Alistar in response to the Cassiopeia once again.
Yeah, Wolf did a great job of zoning.
Yeah, he's a great Alistar player.
The damage threats in that last team fight.
And it's interesting too because Wolf has been the only player in Korea picking up that Alistar kind of in the Cinder Hulk meta. So it's something that's a little bit unique to him. We did see it, of course, from Fnatic as well in this set, but only after a couple of bans on the support role on Yellowstar.
I feel like Yellowstar actually does go with the Nautilus this time around. Annie's a little bit tricky to play into an Alistar Sejuani as well as Azir.
All right, so
Nautilus is much easier to pull off.
We could get the Zed counterpick here again. Obviously, that is very strong.
And Nautilus is available.
Azir.
But again, you're picking the Zed into the Alistar. It was so good at zoning. All right.
See, Fnatic taking their time. Two picks left remaining, either top or mid and support. 20 seconds left on the clock. The counters to the Fnatic team comp they ran previously are again on SK Telecom. Will they pick themselves into another disadvantageous mid to late game setup? 8 seconds left before we find out, Kobe.
All right, so maybe going with the Cassiopeia versus Azir matchup this time around. And SK Telecom played that one against GE, but that was easy Hoon in those matchups in the Korean final.
And this is a very, very thin line that you have to tread in this matchup. It's all about, can the Cassiopeia dodge the Q slow from Azir early on. If she's able to get around that and go aggressive on Azir when that's on cooldown, she can out DPS him straight up one versus one, and he has a really hard time getting away from that. So it's all about if the Azir player can keep her at distance.
We'll find out if Faker can make that happen. One last pick to come in for SK Telecom, T1. And Marin is toying with getting his hands on Rumble yet again. A few seconds left to lock in. Fnatic will be needing to deal with that AP Bruiser in the top lane. And arguably riding that same fine line of engage and fight.
Wow, they really layer it on for the team fights here. Instead of going for the Gnar, the Rumble right into Hecarim. That will give them a lot of dragon control. A Rumble, Sejuani, Sivir mid game here.
Well, they also have the Azir as well to kind of clog up some of those choke points around dragon. Their mid game is going to be extremely strong. Fnatic, on the other hand, while they do have that Lucian versus Sivir matchup in the bottom lane, if we do go 2v2, Cassiopeia and Hecarim are going to have some time. Hecarim really needs some items to be relevant right here. And even his flanks, Wolf is probably going to have a pretty... He'll have a good shot at defending them.
And you have to feel that for Fnatic, they're looking for the skirmishes, not the 5v5s. If you're with that team comp, they can do a whole lot in the 2v2s and 3v3s, but the moment you start layering the top half of SKT's comp together, that becomes terrifying. Glacial Prison into Equalizer. If anything goes wrong, Emperor's Divide to boot them out.
Just that combo right there is almost a teamfight victory.
So Faker taking Cleanse this game as well to deal with the Cassiopeia.
So we'll see that Faker switch over to Cleanse instead of Barrier. And of course, guys, potentially the last game of this semi-final before AHQ and EDG do battle. Can Fnatic take it to 5? Can Fnatic challenge SKT once more? We're loading up onto the Rift. It is SKT 2-1 up, and it is Fnatic on the blue side with another early laning, skirmishing team composition. Let's see them overpower the Rumble and the Sivir.
I wonder, I'm a bit surprised that SKT wanted to play Sejuani. Yes, it's a great pick right here, but it's not something that SKT has shown yet, and it's not something that most teams would consider a threat at this stage. So, wondering if they go through to the rest of this tournament, if that will affect them at all. Huni, skirmishing a little bit right there.
Well, we'll see if he gets into trouble. Three members of SKT around, and a little twirl of Guitar Hero Guitar, and he gets out clean. Defensive right. Starts. It looks like a lane swap from SKT at the moment.
Interesting, because Hecarim has started with just a flask once again, so he's going to have that recall 300 gold after a camp.
Can I just say that's an immobile Cassiopeia dance? I'm being very specific now. See, no longer dancing. Now it's low mobility, Cassie.
Do you really want to fight this fight?
No. I just want to push some buttons. It sounds like the audience is looking forward to it, though. But I concede.
All right. Well, the point I was going to go over is the 300 gold that you go back from doesn't really benefit you when you're going up against an AP top laner one versus one, because the cloth armor does not do Jack all versus Rumble. So we'll see if he just loads up on extra potions, you know, maybe gets an extra ward.
It's possible that he just wanted to wait to see if the lane swap was coming in before he committed to the armor or not, and so he can at least have that flexibility right now as he does the camp. So I think waiting is a clever idea regardless, but we are going to have the 2v2 and the 1v1 as
Yellowstar took. Yeah, he took level 2.
Yep.
I play ADC. I'm like, why? We'll see if this works out.
Bangs a little bit far forward right there. There's the stun.
He's connected. Early exhaust coming out. Yellowstar continues to push Bang away. Let's summon a spell advantage in exchange for the Krug. That's how Yellowstar should have done it yesterday.
Boots. He waited around for an extra few gold. Uh-oh.
Well, Yellowstar and Steelback continuing to trade using that Daylight passive of Leona. And the burst from Steelback early to get some control against Bang and Wolf, but Wolf should be able to heal that up in the not-too-distant future.
So you wait a little bit longer to get to lane if you're going to wait for the boots. But definitely worth it there for Huni. As we said, the cloth armor wouldn't do much for him, so He's going to have an extra damage as well as speed to avoid ganks in the top lane. However, he may run dry from just chugging on the flask and not having any actual health potions to go through.
We did see Huni teleporting up top. We did see the lanes evening out. Small advantage to Yellowstar steal back, and let's see if Yellowstar continues to play aggressively. The answer appears to be yes, but Wolf interrupts the Zenith Blade and knocks him away.
Here's Huni's answer to that all-in to wait a couple seconds for the boots. He goes super aggressive, shoves the lane as soon as he gets up there. Yes, he doesn't have teleport again, but he pushes it all the way in, chugs his crystalline flask, gets some damage down, and then retreats. The bottom lane, though, that's much more exciting.
Yellowstar pretending to play Bard, going on a journey. Bang, does have flash available and spell shield. Summoner spells blown. Two flashes from a gank from Rainover. This mega aggro Yellowstar is doing work for Fnatic.
Yeah, great early call there from Fnatic for that early level two, and they've really taken quite a substantial advantage, and they have that preferable lane. SK Telecom decided to opt into it, even though they were the ones bullying Steelback and Yellowstar out earlier in this game, or this series, I should say.
Rainover, though, if he doesn't return... Oh, looks like Yellowstar is in position, actually.
Well, let's see if he can connect with the Zenith Blade. That is the target. Yellowstar level 3. He's going to start charging up. Stun gets spell shielded. Zenith Blade does not. Steelback looking to get the damage down. He flashes in. Auto attack. Plus Yellowstar. First blood secured for the captain of Fnatic.
Rainover doesn't have to return. Yellowstar is going to take the ganks into his own hands.
Again, finding a really good angle there. Coming in from the lane. Now here is Rainover. Marn's pushed up. He doesn't have vision. A bit dangerous. Huni's going to push him back.
There is a flash available for Marn. Rainover's looking to get the knockup. He's going to tunnel forward. Flash reply. Flash in follow. Marn's going to go down. And Rainover 2-0. Keep in mind, it's what Fnatic need to do with this comp. Now here comes a battle pig. Steelback's in reply. Knocked back up into the air. Bengi, with the help of Wolf, gets one. Yellowstar's in trouble, but he should be able to get away. SKT punish Steelback and Yellowstar sticking around longer than they should have.
Yeah, Wolf starts channeling the Pulverize before the stun comes in from Yellowstar, gets the knockup. That's all the time they need to get a retribution kill in the bottom lane.
Mara going back, getting the arm guard, just building for the lane right now. It'll slow down him down in terms of that magic penetration, however. Faker and Forbiven just about even in mid.
Wow, Forbiven says, I don't care about the Q. I'll just eat it and reply with some Twin Fangs.
Also, be wary once he pops level 6. The all-in from Cassiopeia does have the damage. Right now, Faker has both summoners available, though, so without jungle support, the all-in is unlikely.
I'll take a look at the minimap, guys. Yellowstar and Steelback have moved up to the top lane. Marin getting close to Equalizer. It looks like Rainover wants to set something up. The minion wave is going to get close to that tower shortly.
They have a cannon minion.
See if they can make it work. Marn, he's just hit level 6. Equalizer instantly comes down, but he's instantly knocked up and he's overheating. Yellowstar tanking up the turrets. Now it's Rainover. That's going to take a few shots. It's Rainover. That's going to go down. Marn in a 1v3.
I think he could
secure
tanked,
as a kill.
I think Yellowstar could have tanked one more tower shot.
Yeah, I think they could. SKT also going for the dragon at the same time. And right there, Marin just laying down the equalizer to cut people off and take out the minion wave at the same time to get that turret actually attacking someone as fast as possible.
All right, SKT will secure the dragon. We'll need to see if Fnatic can take that top tower. There's another minion wave pushing up. It looks like Steelback's backed away. And the answer to that question is no. Thank you, Observer Team.
It's a bit interesting that Fnatic decided to put Steelback in the top side right there, considering that it does give up a lot of the pressure that they would have had onto the dragon. And yes, they tried to make a play out of it, but they couldn't take the turret. It ended up trading one for one on a bit of a misplayed dive.
I think what they're looking for here is to try and keep the Rumble really, really far down so that he's not able to...
No, sure, but he already has an arm guard, so it's going to be hard to get that advantage with Steelback, even at the range.
And early on, the dragon buff just itself, just the single dragon, is not going to do a whole lot for the team. So unless they're really worried about the chain stacking there from SKT, keeping the Rumble really far down increases their chances of being able to win a team fight later on towards the next dragon. Here comes the early off guard.
Here comes Huni indeed. Yellow Star flashes forward. Huni gets punted backwards. Onslaught of Shadows once the spell shield comes up, but the exhaust is going to mitigate his damage. And all of a sudden, Fnatic commits a whole lot. Don't get anything in return.
This is why I really like the Alistar pick against Fnatic, because it actually stuffs a lot of these early dives on the bottom side that Fnatic like to do.
And Wolf is going to find Yellowstar hugging a tree line. He gets booted into the jungle of SKT, trying to find his way out. He's going to actually go back in. Zenith Blades onto Alistar. He's maybe going to find the support, but it looks like Huni's about to come up. This could start a team fight. It's taken less to start fights for Fnatic. Yellowstar gets a stun to bang. Here comes Vivin. Three members locked up together. Knock up from Rainover. Look for the petrifying gaze. Yellowstar still alive. Faker stunned up, and he's forced to slide in the back line. Wolfman goes down as Rainover that gets a kill. I think Vivin managed to get a two-man petrifying gaze over the wall, and Fnatic respond well to Yellowstar being caught.
Yeah, really good quick collapse there from Fnatic, and Yellowstar biding his time in the fog of war, waiting for the perfect opportunity to Zenith Blade and gain some extra distance. They also got a bunch of key flashes there. Vivin with the petrifying gaze over the wall as well to stop a lot of the DPS.
Well, worked in their favor. Let's take a look at how this lane swap is working out. CS advantage to Febivin in the mid lane. Equalizer used by Marin.
Yeah, just trying to push up right now, put as much pressure down as possible. Here's Rainover. Marin gonna try and jet out of this one. Will be knocked up and hit with the smite.
Well, it looks like he's potentially gonna go down.
Can he hit it?
Yes, he can!
Great shot.
He took aim. Deep breath in, held it.
Once upon a time, Febivin was referred to as the European sniper for his Xerath plays. Rainover wants to challenge the European mini sniper with his Prey Seeker plays. Can he get over the wall? Yes, he can, because he's flashed into a double knockup. Yellowstar and Rainover now battling Bengi and Wolf. The battle boar is down, and they turn to the battle pig. Now Alistar's trying to get away. Wolf gets knocked up by Rainover. Two more kills. Rainover's done this in Rek'Sai before, and he's doing it again.
And he has the warrior enchantment as well, so the damage coming in is something I think SK Telecom is not expecting right now, and they just kind of overcommitted to that. Bengi also choosing not to throw his ult down. He goes on to Febivin, though.
And Febivin throws his down into a tower. You can't stun that, buddy. Yellowstar does not connect with the Zenith Blade, and at 10 minutes on the clock, Fnatic replay game three with a small lead, but they need to keep this pressure up.
This is actually a fairly substantial lead.
Yeah, it is.
3,000 gold at this stage, and none of it coming from turrets either. That's the big thing. It's not like there's some extra gold. Outer turrets are fairly easy to knock over later for SKT to get back. This is hard, cold cash right here. Fnatic have earned a very strong early lead this time around.
Now we'll see if it'll make a difference. SKT were able to wave clear and dig deep in the previous matchup with an Azir-Ezreal combo. This time it's Azir-Sivir, arguably easier with the Sivir.
A lot of the gold is on Rek'Sai, though. So the distribution...
Ooh.
Well, you know what?
Wow, he's all in.
He's like, you know what? I've got all the gold. Time to carry. Rainover's going to add extra DPS. Bang!
Bang, bang! Steelback shoots you down! Revenge for the pentakill in a stylish culling kill. Rainover, can you find the knockup? No, because Wolf pulverizes and interrupts. Wolf, as well as Bengi, able to get out clean, but Fnatic will take the first tower of the game.
Yeah, but Rainover, even though he didn't get a kill right there, just pushing them that far off of the tower will mean that there's even more gold in Fnatic's pockets, and this control couldn't come at a better time either, right before this dragon's about to spawn.
And that's the reason why Steelback's trying to get the turret down quick and get the lane shoving. Oh, another interrupted tunnel.
And Rainover gets knocked back a million years. Wolf and Faker trying to put damage down, but there's just not enough. That Hicks Drinker helping out as far as the MR is concerned. And that keeps him alive. Yellowstar and Huni. That's a flash from Yellowstar, but Yellowstar misses a solar flare. Marin goes backwards, and the power gets the kill. Fnatic are just everywhere.
That was a predicted flash from Yellowstar. He thought that Marin was going to flash up that way. However, that just means they mistimed his flash. And that just brings up a different problem, which is the timing of summoner spells.
So, Fnatic.
Ooh, rain over.
4,500 gold ahead. Oh, man.
Aran's going to be able to teleport in 3 seconds.
So is Huni. Right. Huni has home guards.
Well, let's see who's going to be more powerful. Rainover gets knocked away, but he's going to tunnel to use. He actually goes in as Marin is teleporting in. 1,000 HP on the dragon. We do see the Prey Seeker coming in. Huni's looking to secure it. It gets picked up by an Alistar of all things. Wolf is low, and Huni does not have Onslaught of Shadows. Yellowstar connects with Bang. We do see the Equalizer coming down as Bengi is caught out. He goes down to Steelback, but they trade his life for Feathervin. Bang, looking for more. He's on the front line. Got his Zia soldiers conquering and shifting the sands all over the place. Fnatic, one for one, but they lost the dragon. That was dragon number two.
Yellowstar looking for that angle. Knock. Gonna find something he likes right there. Faker's still at full HP.
I really don't like Huni using his speed boosted attack on the dragon to try and take it. That is the biggest thing you're bringing to the fight, is when you first get there with Hecarim with the home guard bonus. And after he blows that, they lose a lot of the impact from their top laner coming in. Marin's ultimate comboed with Bengi's ultimate does so much more. And that's how SKT is actually able to bring this one back, even though there's such a large gold deficit. This is why we are talking up that combo of the Sejuani and Rumble.
You also see them 14 minutes on the clock with two dragons. That aspect timer, aspect threat is very real. Fnatic, they do manage to at least put up a decent fight, trading one for one against all of those abilities.
Well, the later this game goes, though, the more Rainover is going to pay for his item build if he can't continue to snowball, too. The reason why we see the Cinder Hulk is because it gives that great multiplicative stat on the HP. So it's so much more powerful in the late game than it is in the early one, and Rainover will simply be blown up.
He'll be blown up, or he'll be kited into futility here. It's so easy to kite Rek'Sai much later into the game. If you do go this full damage, plus you don't have the slowing smite, it's going to be very hard for him to close distance. And you're having to deal with all this AoE, Azir, Sivir's one of the most annoying AD. This looks very, very difficult later into the game for the Fnatic jungler here.
Wow. Very real scared Kobe.
Yes. I do not like jungling into these types of situations.
Well, Rainover doesn't mind thus far.
Right now he's got
to grab the Wraith. He's going to be in a little bit of trouble if Bengi and Wolf decide to engage, but does have support from his duo top. Take a look at the bottom lane. Huni is shoving out towards the inner turret. Rest of Fnatic set their sights on the top lane. Outer turret. There's a battle on a million fronts, and Fnatic are the ones dictating where SKT go.
Yeah, huge gold lead at the moment, too. And they can keep sieging up if they want to. They do have a decent amount of siege right here, but it should be about Rainover just getting deep, trying to scrap in the jungle right now and using this build to its fullest advantage.
And remember, this matchup between Fnatic and SKT, with the teams that they're choosing, it's constantly about Fnatic choosing the team with a much earlier impact. You do not get many chances to make mistakes. You only get a couple here from Fnatic. And that dragon fight was a pretty big one. Are you okay, Steelback? Hello?
Interesting.
Yeah. That may be one of those nooks and crannies on Summoner's Rift.
Or he was just looking somewhere else on the map.
True. I don't know why he would just be standing there.
Well, I think he was looking around to see where everyone was before he walked up further into the lane.
Considering he gave up a death on Sivir yesterday by just standing randomly in a very similar position. Production has confirmed from our observers he could see the ward.
Okay, so.
However, he was not looking on his own screen. Maybe that's what happened yesterday when he died on Sivir.
He couldn't see the ward, but the ref standing behind him looking at his screen.
Screen looking is a bannable offense.
Oh, man. Once again, you're bringing me back to the GoldenEye days.
Yeah.
Dirty screen watcher, aren't you, Trevor?
Hey, it's where the nickname comes from. So, 6,000 gold, 7 kills, 2 towers, but 0 dragons. Evervin has found Bengi 2 level advantage and so much poison. He doesn't manage to get the stun. Follows for Twin Fang. Evervin finds a kill on Bengi but loses his flash to secure it. A minute and a half before Dragon can Fnatic get control of the area. We'll see if they even want to for the time being.
Well, they're in a great position. They have all their outer turrets still up right here and not even that much damage right now because of how dominant they have been in the early game.
Rainover's also going to need to use his smite on the Raptors, get that Oracle's buff to start clearing out their red side jungle. SKT have been able to sneak in a bit deep and get some wards down behind the Dragon Pit already.
Let's see how this plays out. Yellowstar hiding around the side of that mid-outer turret. Huni's actually backing. He does have teleport and those home guard boots. So if a fight were to break out, he could no longer have the home guard because he's running top lane to defend instead. But Fnatic using this gold lead to arrest control.
That's huge,
of
though.
The jungle.
A blue steal away from Azir onto Cassiopeia. The dragon will melt if they do decide to pull the trigger.
Well, I'm sure they will pull the trigger. Fnatic have been doing it all day. Here comes Rainover. He's actually flashed forward, gets the knockup onto Faker, and the solar flare stuns him. Yellowstar does not connect with the Zenith Blade, though. Bang, a little bit in retreat as Bengi is now left alone. 4 members of Fnatic make that 5 members of Fnatic. Will get the kill onto Bengi. 0-5-2. He's been made into boar jerky this game, and Fnatic go towards the dragon.
Itchy trigger finger right there. You caught me? All right, we're fighting then. Instant teleport as well.
I love that decision right there that we saw come in from Rainover. Really smart. Wolf is on a deadly odyssey through the jungle right now. He got cut off on the opposite side of the map.
He did. It's a three-man knockup. I got excited.
The wolf trampoline.
Well, Rainover now. A little bit of trouble, not able to get the crop. 5-1-3 Rainover, 5-1-1 Lucian. The gold is being distributed to the carries now, Kobe. Moving around the map, a little bit of tankiness being picked up for Rainover. They've got the tools to keep fighting at 20 minutes.
Oh, Rainover, what a beautiful flash right there, having such confidence in his team and the follow-up as well with that solar flare, forcing the cleanse out of Faker.
Yeah, he was a split second behind. If that cleanse was a little bit late, Yellowstar Zenith Blade lands, the just 2 shots from the culling would have taken his life as well.
So, 6,000 gold. See the itemizations all the way down. Febivin, Abyssal Scepter, as well as Seraph's Embrace completed. But Fnatic still have an outer turret in the mid lane to knock down. And then they have to set their sights on the inner turrets. And that's where the game stalled. That is where it stalled previously.
And look, SKT just has such exceptional wave clear and turtling capabilities with this composition. They're going to have to go through the Azir Towers. They're going to have to try and siege with a bunch of Sand Soldiers and Boomerang Blades flying at them. So SK Telecom can kind of hold position and turtle into the late game if they have to.
Thing is, with a Cassiopeia this strong, with the blue buff, you can threaten neutral objectives. You don't have to go for turrets.
Well, Fnatic are in full vision. SKT are responding. Wow, this Baron's going super low. 2,300 hit points remaining. I think Baron's secured. It is secured. Solar Flare, it slows Faker. We do see Huni, he goes in. Hourglass has been popped to keep Faker alive as Wolf, he gets a knockup of his own. Huni's gone down and Fnatic are deciding to retreat and peel away.
Great
lost
equalizer.
One, but got the objective.
Yeah, that was...
And bang, on the bottom side of the map right there, too. It's, you have to be so careful. We're already 22 minutes into this game, only I should say. But Vivian is playing this Cassie, and you do have a Lucian that has 2 items as well. It's always a threat with Cassiopeia if you're ahead like this to take that Baron. Great call from Fnatic.
I think that was between games, mid-series coaching. One little change from the last match where they had a similar advantage with a lot of DPS, and we didn't see the focus on vision necessary to pull off that sort of play.
Well, this time, SKT knew. They just committed a lane designation error in terms of having Sivir in the bottom side.
Pretty risky at this stage.
And four out of the five members of Fnatic have upgraded their trinkets, three of which are yellow, so all of those wards going to be littering SK's jungle. And we'll see whether or not Huni can find the teleport, whether or not Fnatic can keep making these picks. You know, Yellowstar leading the front again. It was his work in the bottom lane that got Steel back ahead. It was his roams that started to get Rain over, as fed as he currently is. And Fnatic are knocking on the inner ring of turrets.
Nice split pushing coming in. Only Marin up there. He has his equalizer back up if he wants to use it to clear the wave. Not going to make that call quite yet. Flashes out.
Well, let's see what else Fnatic can get. We do see the Zenith Blade catching onto Wolf, and he's taken down. There was no unbreakable will, so he just gets broken where he stands. Bottom lane, minions pushing towards the tower. Middle lane, it's about to conga its way up. 10,000 gold at 24 minutes.
Yeah, they have to keep their foot on the gas pedal here for Fnatic. Make use of this Baron that they have to get as many towers down as they can.
Well, it looks like the pedal is flat on the floor. Rainover is going to sacrifice his life for the tower. The rest of Fnatic secure the objective and start to peel away. That was a petrifying gaze, but Fevervin gets stunned. SKT looking to find a target. Not available for them just yet. Fnatic lose one, but they've secured two inner turrets. As well as an outer, so three turrets, in fact, since Baron was secured. Very, very strong play, and another blue buff seal, Kobe.
I actually would not be surprised for Fibbivin to build an early Quicksilver Sash this game as well. You cannot afford to have that happen again. Now his flash is down, and he didn't go cleanse like Faker did.
We'll see if he agrees. Baron about to wear off for Fnatic, and that starts to send everybody back. They're sitting on a lot of money. Over 2.5K for Fevervin, over 2,300 for Steelback. He feels power right now is what he needs. BF Sword as well as an Elixir to look to do more battle.
And Dragon coming up in 45. SKT is going to have a very difficult time contesting this one as it is.
All right, so if Fnatic are able to set up for it, they do have plenty of wards leading up to the Dragon inside those jungle corridors. But Faker secures the Crab.
2 hourglasses and a locket on the side of SK, but they're fighting a team with a 10,000 gold lead.
And this Fnatic team has a lot of damage over time, and the Zonyo is not quite as effective. We may see Faker go for one of those Azir plays if he sees someone out of position where he puts his own body at risk.
And let's see what he can find. Rainover's going to be the target. SKT committing onto the jungle. Oh. Huni's looking for somebody to catch out. Wolf is left alone. He may be going down, but
Dragon
will in fact get away. And that means SKT unable to challenge for Dragon now.
Yeah. Well, they tried to get a pick right there, and actually the team fighting and defense was really quite good, but They're going to go for it.
Careful! That's a great equalizer from Marin, but I don't think it'll be enough. Wolf falls. He doesn't have unbreakable will. Fevervin turns onto Marin. The poison goes out. That's two down. Faker drops immediately after, and Bang is being run down by Huni. He's decided to back away. Bengi forced to flash to stay alive. 5-on-2 in the middle lane.
That's exactly what Fnatic want. They want to draw you to the neutral objectives in the middle of the map.
Yeah, and now they can take it. So they're, SKT, they felt they had to fight this Dragon. This has been a problem, I think, over the course of this series. Fighting a Dragon's when they're behind, they're playing into Fnatic's hands, and that's going to be an inhibitor. And it looks very unlikely that SKT is going to come back from this one.
2-1 in the series. If Fnatic can close this out, we will be going to a deciding game. And for Fnatic, they will be on the red side. If Fnatic close this out,
on the brink of making history.
Yeah, making history. The first Western team since 2012 to beat a Korean team in a best of five.
Well, let's not get too ahead of ourselves. They have to finish this game first.
Let's take a look at it because
team fight.
It's Bang leading the charge into the Dragon. So no matter how good of an equalizer you're going to get, that combo, they just annihilate him. Faker also is right behind, so he's on the front lines, and Steelback right in his face. They're just all over them. Plus, the Zonyas for Marin doesn't do anything. As we said, This is a damage over time team. Pavivin just waits around. Okay, now your Zhonya's done and you're dead.
Why would you fight when you're 10k gold down? That is a question for the ages.
Well, there's also no threat of getting a huge number
it's
of dragons.
It's only a two, right?
Right
there.
High. And you are your team comp is so good at defending. Just play passively. SK Telecom really overcommitting here, and Fnatic punishing them in a major way.
So Baron spawning in 40 odd seconds. SKT have had control of the crabs the last few tries, so a little bit of vision on Fnatic. And we'll see if those trinkets and sightstone will give Fnatic the vision they need to do another Baron play. We saw how quickly it went down 7 minutes ago. It'll go down even faster this time round.
Man, the support itemization is just leaps and bounds ahead as well. Yellowstar, fully completed Aegis. Distortion boots to boot so he can continue to make these plays where he flashes forward in extremely long range. Screens ahead possibilities of initiation for this Leona.
I'd like to draw everyone's attention very quickly to the pink ward that's still back left standing. It is still left standing in the top lane. Not that it's integral, but I think it's fun.
Obviously, it has not done much to help the SKT.
All right, here we go.
If Morin wants to teleport, he could. But he doesn't have teleport.
No, he can't.
So
Trevor.
He can't. I'm getting a bit ahead of myself. Hooney looks like he wants to zone away SKT.
5,000, well, and they let it regen.
Yeah, they didn't really have the wards deep enough in the jungle to make that work. So SK Telecom will stall them out for just a little bit.
Now that they've already cracked in the inhibitor line, the one thing they're truly scared of is clumping up inside a Baron pit and getting hit with a Sedgel. If that happens, you lose the entire game.
Yes, because Azir's damage combined
you're
with
done.
The Equalizer, it doesn't really matter how far ahead you are, you will just all die. So I think that the level of patience, good right there. Rainover trying to take away this blue buff. Faker gonna pop a soldier over the wall, but Rainover will grab it away.
Is that three in a row now that Fnatic has stolen from SKT? Faker's resources dwindling as we creak across 30 minutes.
Creak? Are we on a rickety bridge? Quick shot.
That's not rickety. I think this is a pretty solid bridge to victory for Fnatic.
Yeah, looks to be the case. Teleport's available for Morin. He's going to be coming in. Will in fact be through the river.
And there's the Sivir ult down already.
And the teleport burned.
All right, there's no vision here for Fnatic. Rainover has been the bait that has started multiple Fnatic fights in this game. And Fnatic, slow and steady, gets you to the game five deciding bout.
Yeah, Fnatic wants to fight right here. They just recalled and Hecarim is sitting in Fountain. So they want to make use of that ability while they can. They may try and go back onto the Baron right now and force it with the home guard Hecarim coming in. Here we go.
Here comes Hooney. Faker's knocked up. Hourglass comes out. Yellowstar and Rainover are the only ones caught by the Glacial Prison. Faker in retreat. Hooney throws down the Onslaught of Shadows, and the Equalizer will at least dissuade Fnatic's aggression. Hooney on the full back off, and Fnatic are somewhat split. They are going to find Bang, though, as a multi-man knocker from Wolf will slow things down, but ultimately not affect the outcome. Rainover sinks his fangs into Faker, and that is a 1-for-3 trade.
And that should be the game for Fnatic. Grab Baron, shove on in, destroy the rest of the base. Huge, huge gains here. It does look like we're headed towards game number 5.
I would not have thought that coming into the game. But what an exciting series this has been.
Quickshot is doing a dance that I wish we could show you guys right now.
It's always awesome to go to game 5. And I had the pleasure of doing game 5 games in every European playoff match from semifinals to third place to finals. And now luckily in the semifinals at the MSI, we get a deciding battle between Europe and Korea. Considering how shaky Fnatic looked over the group stage,
and
this is such an incredible growth.
And even in the EU-LCS playoffs, they really have brought their A game here, and it's a much, much different team.
There is still yet time.
That is true. They still have to close it out.
If Steelback in the Pink Ward, the legend of Steelback in the Pink Ward is any indication. then maybe they won't look at their screen.
Somebody needs to tell us how long that pink ward's been alive. Because it's going to be pretty epic as Dragon number 3 secured by Fnatic. 15,000 gold, roughly, ahead. 5 towers. The only tower that's fallen is the mid lane tower from Fnatic, and they've taken everything else. And we do see Huni takes a lot of damage from Faker. He doesn't commit. With Faker not there,
the rest of Fnatic, Faker.
They feel brave. When you see the stun onto Faker, Zenith Blade will be available. That's a very early hourglass. Solar Flare will stun Faker in place, and Onslaught of Shadows goes forward. We do see Yellowstar.
Faker's still alive!
Faker's still alive! And we do see Yellowstar going down. Could this be bad? Bengi survives to live again. The poison not going to tick away, and we do see Niba Bang actually defending against the threat from Fnatic. So Inhibitor went down, Fnatic got supers again in the middle lane, and it is a 4v5 if they want to carry on.
There is still time yet, Trevor. SKT are not going down that easy. Two members escape with 100 HP. What an extraction there, airlifting Faker out. After a really well-timed Solar Flare from Yellowstar.
Yeah, they did all they could, but the Emperor's Divide bought him just a little bit more time.
You've got to think, did they really need to go all in, considering they could get that inhibitor? It is Faker after all. Observers have informed me, ladies and gentlemen, that this ward has been alive since 15 minutes, 44 on the clock.
That's some value right there.
We're about to breach 20 minutes lifespan on a ward. That is a ward cheer I will permit in this building.
If it ends up doing anything in this game, then I'll be surprised.
It has given us a distraction for 40 seconds. Right. It has done its job.
I think really the saddest part about that is whoever placed that ward hasn't placed another pink ward since then. I think that's the saddest part, honestly.
Well, what if it's Marn or something? Ah, top laner.
It is, in fact, Marn that placed it. Production has just confirmed. He has not invested in another pink ward. So, shall we get ourselves back on track here, gentlemen?
All right. Rainover got caught. Knocked out of the tunnel.
Stunned up with the minions. Bengi and Faker still running him down. He gets knocked back and taken down. Fnatic, the seams are a little loose.
That was a pretty big investment for that kill, though. They had to use two ults to kill him.
Well, will it cost him anything more? Here comes Fnatic. Huni wants Bang, and he's almost going to solo him. Onslaught of Shadows is available. Culling has been channeled, and we do see Bang forced to flash away. Equalizer is good. Steal back on the retreat. Throws out the Lifeslinger and the auto attacks onto Marin. Huni kicks him with the hoofs. He onslaughts in. He fears them backwards, and that's three kills for Fnatic. Faker is down, but he takes Steal back with him. Fnatic continue to chase. We do see Bang going out. Ladies and gentlemen, we are going to game 5. Fnatic take down SKT in the fourth battle to push us all the way to the MSI semifinals.
And those advantages that Fnatic is getting out of the laning phase have really just propelled them to these victories. SK Telecom not skirmishing as well, and Fnatic just snowballing this game out.
So, such good execution from Fnatic this time around, drawing SKT out into the open, around the neutral objectives, and then crushing them.
Crowd is on their feet. And Fnatic find the team comp and allows their aggression to accelerate their lead. A little nerve-wracking towards the end, but they closed it out, and we're going to game 5.
Yeah, and you got to give a lot of credit to Yellowstar that game, too, because, I mean, even from the get-go, just getting that level 2 and getting that lane advantage turned out to be huge. They kept popping summoners. They got that first blood on the bottom side. They knew exactly what their game plan was going to be, and it was something that they hadn't showed before either, and something that certainly SKT was not ready for.
And Yellowstar's Leona is still impeccable. The entire game, the whole way through, is Annie was great previous game. Anyways, we're going to throw it over to the analyst desk to break down game 4 as we get ready for the fifth and final match.